I'm Megan. I live in USA. I am 5 years old.
Almost?
Six.
When Reagan was born, she was a healthy baby. They did not know at the time that she had SMA. When she was probably about 8 months old, she didn't roll over, she didn't sit up, no head control. So they took her to the doctor, and before the testing was done, she got pneumonia. They didn't think that she was going to make it. She was in a coma for about 4 months. At the time, she got a trach. She was on a ventilator. And while she was in the hospital, she got a diagnosis of spinal muscular atrophy, 1. The doctor said that she probably wouldn't make it till 2, so they sent her home and just told mom and dad to kind of love her and enjoy the last few months they had with her. So, as you can see, Reagan's almost 6 years old. Reagan doesn't like to be told what she's going to do. Every therapist we go to in the U.S. says she's not going to get any better, she's not going to improve. But Reagan had a baby brother who passed away from the same disease. And right after he passed away, we really decided we need to do something. Because with this disease, the children degrade. So when we come, our only hope was that she just would stop getting worse. So we didn't realize that she would actually get better. But she got a lot better for us, didn't you, Reagan?
Yeah. We went last year.
We did come last year. Reagan didn't have head control. If you sat her up, she just fell over. She couldn't really move her legs. She had very little hand control. Well, since we come and did this, she can sit up. Let's show them your big girl head. You ready? And to her, that's independence. To her, that's, I'm a big girl, just like the rest of the world. So can you show them how to dance? Show them how to dance. Gotta use the head. So to her, that's everything. With the occupational therapy, she's having to use both hands. I think mom will see that she has more hand control. Like today, she was painting. Before, it would be too long for her. So I think mom will see a big difference, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah?
That's beautiful, Raven.
Yeah, with me, okay?
She can feed herself now. Like, she can pick up her food and put it in her mouth. When before she was a baby, we had to feed her like a baby. So now she's truly a big girl. She can cough when she never could before. So now Reagan has an open, hold on, pick up your neck. Reagan has an open stoma still that we can use to suction. We've suctioned her maybe once since we've been here, and that was just climate change. When before we came here last year, we suctioned 30, 40 times a day. So it's little things that make it worth the trip. So now we eat by mouth, we have head control, we can color, we can draw, and this trip, she has learned to, as much as she can learn, she's learned to swim. They put her into her little vest, and she uses her arms, and she uses her feet, and they've taught her to swim. Use all of your body, you know, all of your strength, and she can swim. Like, we video chatted with Dad, and Dad was just crying. Like, it's, like, that is a lot for us, just the little things. What do we call the hyperbaric chamber? What do you call it?
Rocket ship.
Rocket ship. You can feel when you get into the hyperbaric chamber, when you get in, you don't quite understand what it's doing for you. But Reagan has damage to her right lower lung from a collapse as a baby. And when she gets into the hyperbaric, you can hear that she's breathing. You could hear the bottom lobe was open more.
She's put on the weight. She looks better. She looks good. She looks healthy. So the diet works. When we weighed her last week, we were all jumping around and happy because she's gained so much weight. That's, to us, that's a lot of weight. A pound is just phenomenal.
So. When you first come here and you've never done it, you don't know a lot, you think the stem cells alone are the cure, the answer, the magic that you're looking for. Well, then you get here and they start to educate you that it's the stem cells, in theory, are going to try to repair what you need repaired, in theory. So that's your hope. You're hoping that they go straight to the brain or the muscles or whatever your child's problem is. But if your child has other issues, it doesn't know where to repair. So they try to teach you that the nutrition is a main part of it, and then they go from there. So they teach you that it's all of it. You can't just come and get the stem cells. It don't work that way. So you have to get every bit of it.
She called home and told her daddy that she was getting chunky.
There's a lot of therapy here. She works very hard all day. So we do get tired. But they're constantly working every single aspect of her.
One, two, three.
What's your favorite therapy?
My favorite therapy.
And why? Why do you like that one the best?
Because it helps me get stronger.
Because it helps you get stronger. That's a good answer. We have plans to come back every year because it works. The therapies, the stem cells, all together it works. I guess it frustrates you to look back and realize that a whole group of doctors, a whole group of people was willing to just not try, just to give up because the book said children with this disease or this disorder, this is what happens to them. If we would have listened to the doctors, she would still be on a trach, she would still be on a ventilator. Her quality of life would just continue to break down. The therapists are like, well, she's never gonna get head control, so we're not even gonna think about working on head control. When they can, she's proof they can. So I just think that at some point the doctors have to realize that other things work. It's not a miracle, it's not a cure. You're not gonna walk out of here tomorrow, obviously, but it improves the quality of their life. Either it's 5 years, 10 years, or the rest of their lives. It makes a difference. Each year she's getting stronger, so we'll be back next year. Are you a tough cookie?
Yeah.
Thank you. ขอบคุณค่ะ